That's enough of the interactive shell for now. Let's write our first program. In idle, click on File, New File. This makes the file editor window appear. Enter the following code. I'll explain what it does afterwards. A pound. This program says hello and asks for my name. Have a blank line, followed by print hello world, print what is your name, pound ask for their name, my name equals input, print is good to meet you, plus my name. Print the length of your name is print len my name. Print what is your age. Pound symbol ask for their age. My age equals input. Print you will be plus string int my age plus one plus in a year. Save this program as hello.py. Python programs are just text files that have the .py file extension. Then click on Run, Run Module, or just press F5 to run the program. Hello world, what is your name? Al. It is good to meet you, Al. The length of your name is 2. What is your age? 26. Yeah, I am 26. You will be 27 in a year. I remember when that was true. Okay, that's the entire program. One thing to keep in mind is that Python will start at the first instruction at the top of the program, and then move downwards, executing each instruction in turn. Think of it as putting your finger on the top instruction, and as each instruction is executed, moving your finger down to the next instruction. This is just like how you might move your finger along the lines of a book that you're reading. Your finger is called the execution. The execution in Python starts at the top and moves down. So the first line with the pound sign is called a comment. Python ignores comments. You can use them to write notes to yourself or reminders about what the code is trying to do or what the entire program does. Blank lines are completely ignored by Python. You can just use these to space out your code. In fact, let's add a couple more blank lines, maybe right here, just to group together the code that's relevant to asking for your name and the code that asks for your age. The print function displays the string value inside the parentheses on the screen. So the line print hello world means print out the text in the string hello world. Functions in Python are like mini programs in your program. They contain code that do various things, and for your convenience, Python comes with a lot of them. In code, a function is its name, followed by parentheses. And optionally, sometimes there are values passed to the function inside the parentheses. In this context, these values are called arguments, but really values and arguments are the exact same thing. This is called calling the print function when we have code like this here. So the next instruction is also a call to the print function. This time it's passing the what is your name string to the print function. There's also a comment at the very end of the line. You can always add comments to the end of an instruction since everything after that pound sign will just be ignored by Python. When the input function is called, Python waits for the user to type some text on the keyboard and press enter. Just like a variable will evaluate to the value it contains, calls to the input function evaluate to the string value of what the user typed. So if I typed in Al when input was called, this my name variable assignment statement we just evaluate to Al. And then the string Al gets stored inside of my name. Remember that expressions can always evaluate down to a single value. So if Al is stored in my name, then this is what that call to the print function looks like. First, my name evaluates to the value inside of it. And then this is just a string concatenation. So the next step looks just like this. So this is the string that gets passed to the print function call. This next line introduces a new function called len. What len does is it takes a string argument and then evaluates to the integer value of the length of the string, which is the number of characters in the string. Let's just experiment with this function in the interactive shell for a little bit. So I can call the length function and pass it al, and it returns 2. Let's say Albert returns 6, or length the blank string, and that returns 0. And then I can just use these function calls to len anywhere I could use an integer. So I could say, you know, if I typed out my name 10 times, its length would be 20. So then we have some more print and input calls. This time we're saving whatever the user types into the variable myAge. And then we have this line, which introduces the string and int functions. Now this seems really complicated, so we'll just take this one step at a time. The string and int functions return string and integer values of whatever you pass them. So this is really handy if you need to convert between data types. So in the interactive shell, you can have something like string of the value 26, and that returns a string value with 26 in it. And if you have to go the opposite route, you can call the integer function and pass it a string value like 1, 2, 3, 4, and it will return an integer value. There's also a float function that you can use to convert something to a floating point value. So if you can pass a string to it, it'll return a float value, or if you pass an integer value to it, it will return a floating point version value of that integer. Notice it has the decimal point and point zero. This may seem pointless, but remember that the input function always returns a string value, even if the string value is something like 26. And we can't do math on a string, that returns an error. First, we have to get an integer value of it, so that's why we pass it to the int function. And just like you can't do addition on strings, you can't do string concatenation on integers. So we're going to have to call the string function, convert that into a string value. This is what the entire last line looks like when Python evaluates it. First, the myAge variable will evaluate to the value that's inside of it, and then that gets passed to the int function, which returns an integer form of it. We add 1 to that integer. We have to convert that back to a string value because we want to concatenate it with the other strings next to it. And then after that, it's just the string concatenations. And so all of this just reduces down to this string, which we pass to the print function call, which then gets it displayed on the screen. And that's how the entire program works. Just to recap, the file editor is where you type in code for a program. The execution starts at the top and then proceeds down, executing each instruction in turn. Comments begin with a pound sign and are just notes that are ignored by Python. They're just notes for the programmer. Functions are kind of like mini programs that your program can run to execute some code that does some specialized thing. In this case, the print function has code for making strings appear on the screen. There's a print function for making text appear on the screen. There's an input function for getting text from the keyboard. And there's also a string int and a float function that returns an integer, string, or float version of the values that you pass to them.